this was a wonderful piece that came from Japan. When I first came to Oberlin in 1972, I heard about her record. She made a record, a beautiful record. Remember recordings? Anybody remember records when they were like big? They were really big, you know? And the artwork was pretty cool. That was one of the things about it, was that the artwork was really kind of nice. And actually, the collector's items now. But anyway, she did this album, and I loved the music, and it was completely new because since then, nowadays, there's dozens and dozens of pieces, right, for Merlin. There wasn't then. There was only two or three pieces in the early 70s. But now, obviously, there's more. So I was really thrilled to have a piece like this at that time. So I believe it or not, this is actually a true story. I didn't know where to get the music because there was no distribution, there was no net World Wide Web, there was no way to get the music. So what I did was, I was a Japanese student here at the time, from Japan, and I asked her, I said, do you know Akira Miyoshi? Oh, she said, oh yes, very famous composer in Japan. I said, do you know his telephone number? She said, no, how would I know that? I said, could you do me a favor and call up your parents and ask Milk in the telephone book? And this is the literal truth. I'm sitting in my studio, and I just called him on the phone, long distance, hello, Mr. Miyoshi. He said, yeah. I said, I'm Mike Rosen calling from America. Would you send me your music? He said, sure. So he sent me the music, and it was in manuscript, all handwritten, and I still have a copy of it. And this was one of the pieces. He sent about three pieces, and I was the first person to play these pieces in America, and then I did play a couple of them in Europe, too. So let me tell you a little bit about it. And it's and the name is kind of funny, because it's called Time for Marimba. And you think to yourself, yeah, time. Passage of time. I'm getting older. Oh, it's time to do something. Time. You know, and the truth behind the story is that Akira Miyoshi went to, Keiko Abe went to Akira Miyoshi and said, would you write a piece for me? He said, I'm so busy, I don't have time. Okay. A year later, he said, okay, now, will you write a piece for me? He said, no, I'm sorry, I have so much to do, I don't have time. And finally, after about 3 years, he said, okay, I'll write a piece for you, because now I have time for marimba. I guess you could probably give it some sort of a philosophical or deeper meaning, but it's not what it was meant originally. All right, so let me tell you a little bit about the piece so you can enjoy it a little bit more. There's two themes in it, and you'll hear them coming back. It's a variation. It's a theme of variations. Is this, and you're going to hear that several times. You'll hear a different key, right? You'll hear it separated, you'll hear it all sorts of different ways, so listen for that. And the other theme you'll hear is this. Thank you. Movements on the premise that empires don't actually fall from without. It's not because actually they're conquered by the outside conquerors, but historically the empires are already crumbling from within. So his commentary on the state of America at that time was to make a series of pieces where there's a prologue and then six different characters, completely different characters, and each character speaks his or her text from a different percussion instrument.
And each of these characters actually have nothing to do with one another, but it's a snapshot of some unraveling of the fabric of the society in one way or another. So tonight I'll do for you just the prologue, the introduction to the whole piece, and then three of the characters. The texts happen to be, in this case, the first two are actually Frederick's texts of Frederick himself, and the third one is a retelling of a story written by Mark Twain. I mean, Mark Twain retells a somewhat then well-known story of a particular religious fanatic. Jefferson. I tremble for my country. When I reflect that God is just, and that his justice cannot sleep. In the beginning, there was nothing. Then, there was something. Why something? Something is work. Nothing is easy. We think we are something. It's going to end.
doesn't care what you think. His sights are set lower. He cares about you Sabbath day. As usual. Nobody keeping it. Nobody but our family. Multitudes of the wicked swarming everywhere and carousing, drinking, fighting, dancing, gambling, laughing, shouting, singing. And the noise, blowing horns, banging on pots and pillows, blaring brazen instruments, boom, clatter, drums. It's enough to burst a person's ears. Have come in even greater crowds than usual today to look at the altar and prowl over and make fun. They ask questions, and when they are told it is a law, they laugh and ask where the water is. Out here on the dry plain. When we say, the Lord is going to send the waters from heaven and drown to the Marines.
The German word Zeit. Zeichnung means drawing or sketch in the sense that an artist might make such a thing. Fritz Hauser is a percussionist in Switzerland, mostly a drum set player, very interestingly a jazz player who then became very interested in having avant-garde composers write things for him to play on the drum set. And the more he explored other people's ideas about how to play a traditional drum kit, the more he had ideas himself about what to do. So this little piece, Just for Suspended Cymbals, is a drawing not in the sense of being a sketch, not in that it's a study in any sense, but it's a drawing in probably the refined use of, it's just pen and ink. It's not lots of different things to do, but one follows very carefully the simple lines of this very simple piece. He composed carefully not only the initiation of the sound, but the cessation of the sound as well, to help find where these little counterpoints and melodies are.
Thank you.